everybody, to this, the spring concert of the Composer's Orchestra. This orchestra, as you may or may not know, is set up to play uniquely premieres. And so all of these works that you hear tonight, including Piano Concerto in C by Annabelle Duff, if you'd like to clap the composer. So all of the works that you hear tonight are composed by brand new composers. All of the music is completely new. We have spent a long time this semester, and indeed a very long time today, making sure that everything goes as well as possible. The conductor you see here is Paul Tolan, a fellow music student. My name is Ethan, I'm the president, so welcome from me. I've been asked to do a bit of introduction to some of the pieces. First off, some of the pieces, unfortunately, due to last-minute illness, have had to be cut. So if you do have one of these, well done. If you don't, there is a QR code you can scan at the front door. We didn't think of bringing one in here, so you can't do it in here. You have to leave. But some of the pieces, unfortunately, that have had to be cut include the opera Goldilocks and the Three Bears and Rain. Those two pieces have to be cut because of illnesses, but everything else will go ahead as planned. And so you just hear Piano Concerto in C by Annabelle Duff, and the next piece is La Durée Foule, I hope I'm saying that correctly, by Valerie Thibault. And I hope you enjoy this one as well. ourselves into too many concerts today, and so isn't actually here to get the round of applause. But you can choose another. You can just clap the conductor, I suppose. and the next piece is called Snow Giant. Thank you. Jamie's not here today, but that was a piece by Jamie Argo known as Snow Giant. So yeah, clap at the conductor and prepare. The next piece is by Cherry Gallagher, and it's called A Worm. This is another piece similar to the piano concerto that was originally composed just for the piano, and then was slowly grown out of that, this sort of orchestral arrangement. And this piece says that it sounds like a worm squirming through some earth, going about its worm life. Good job.
Thank you.
So this is a piece that, once again, sort of is born of the piano and then sort of grows out of that into the orchestra. This piece sort of centers on a very still arpeggiated sequence that builds from there. Now that the pianist is ready, I'll get out of the way. Thank you.
Thank you.
much as we have picked very completely different pieces, I'm noticing as I'm talking about them quite a lot of similarities perhaps in the thought process. We've had a few pieces that started off with the piano, and now we're going to have another piece that belongs in a cycle of seven. This is Somnia from the Epitome. This is Epitome from the Somnia Cycle by Ricardo Mercado Camathos. I hope I said that right. Ricardo is nodding, so I did, good. And this is a dream. I will quote, "It's said that dreams are only real while they last, but if you believe in them, they will be forever eternal." from the soil to the tips of winter tree twigs. How's it looking? Are they set up yet? Yeah? Oh, our light has come on. Okay.
Thank you.
Yes, would the composer like to stand? I can see you at the back. Coming back, we are moving now on to the slightly shorter but just as interesting second half of the concert, and hopefully somebody will walk in at some point. For the first half of this, first little section, we're going to be swapping from our usual conductor Paul to the composer of the first three pieces, one of which sadly, it was going to be four pieces, one of which is sadly being cancelled on sickness. Here they come, aren't they? Thank God, they're still here. It'd be really bad if you guys came back with me. Anyway, so the first three pieces are a series of four grand miniatures by Craig Morrison, who plays percussion for us, and piano, and now is going to become a conductor and then briefly a singer. So please welcome the composer and conductor for this section, Craig Morrison.
Thank you.
and Grebes. And the name of the piece is Dance of the Grebes by Amelia Kibble. Who's over there? I looked in the right direction.
Thank you.
mythology, and specifically the tale of Pandora's Box. This piece will take you through the journey from Pandora's descent from the gods all the way to the release of hope that remained in her box at the end of her story. So, hope beyond all evil. two chamber pieces. The first is called Fantasia and is a string quartet. A string quintet. It's a string quintet. And then there's a prologue for piano, which is by me. I will hand over now to Freddie, who will introduce his piece and then perform in mine. So a round of applause for Freddie, please.
My piece is a Fantasia. It's a collection of parts that flow together. They don't have much effect in them, but that's what a Fantasia is. I do recommend you think about how the next sections differ and how they flow and how they play with musical temperature, but I'm going to take a seat here in the audience to listen to it, because I've not heard it fully yet. So, away, guys. Thank you.
ginger locks. You look more like a leprechaun than a music maestro.
What? You call yourself a composer. You call yourself a composer. Your pieces are about as interesting as watching Paint Dry on those flamboyant shirts of yours.
I like paint.
Beat it. Shut up. Beat it, tiny tunes.
You else want to be a stick chain of triangle, pal?
Me!
337. Originally composed for solo piano, this piece has been adapted and expanded for the composer's orchestra. It centers on a haunting melody that slithers through my ears and reminds me of a worm squirming through some earth, going about its worm life. But the chords underneath the melody remain repetitive and simple, much like a worm days after a worm. Worm days pass, each mundane and unremarkable, worm day after worm day. Yet the music changes as the worm encounters stones and fellow worms, and perhaps even worm danger. As I delve into the work, I find myself drawn to the worm, reminiscent of a serpent rising from forbidden depths. The music, its melody both captivating and unsettling, whispers secrets of a hidden world beneath this.
The orchestra mirrors the worm's descent, guiding me along a path I scarce comprehend. Worm teeps its facet composition, their eerie resilience and cryptic jest from beyond. The conductor's background, once innocuous, now commands with mesmerizing undulations and hypnotic wriggles, stirring something primal within, a sinister worm made unto itself. The worm's symphony regains its insidious grip on my mind. Transcends beyond it, it heralds an unraveling of our souls. The worms, enigmatic denizens of the underground beckoning with unseen hands. I feel a growing compulsion, a pull toward an unknown abyss. Yet I resist, clinging to my gravity as the worm whispers temptation to my ear. Symphony crescendos of a sensitive arc, energy pulsating with my veins, twisting my very thoughts, consuming my essence. How am I losing myself at my question? But the allure of the worm grows stronger. I'm no longer merely an observer. I am becoming a part of this unholy symphony. And as the final notes fade into a haunting silence, I ride with newfound purpose. I am no longer human. I am worm. My list is ensnared in a writhing abyss of damn flesh.
Thank you. concerts and stuff. I've been a member of the orchestra for 2 years now. This is my first time conducting it, and it's just been an amazing opportunity.
And thank you so much for those of you who came last time, and actually did find out that this time it was a real interval. We still have some of those biscuits left, so when you do leave, try to take at least one so we can get rid of them. But really, thank you very much for coming. Well, thank you very much for coming, and hopefully see you next semester in the same place. Thank you.